A restaurant printer offers numerous benefits that greatly enhance the efficiency and effectiveness of operations in a food establishment. It does so by creating an effective communication channel between the front of house and the back of house of a restaurant. There are two types of restaurant printers. Thermal printers are printers that operate by driving heated pins against special heat-sensitive paper to burn the image onto the paper. These types of printers are ideal for restaurants because of their increased printing speed. And since the printer does not require ink, that leads to reduced operating cost. Normal printers such as laser and inkjet are not practical for hot, humid kitchens because these conditions distort prints on regular paper. Thermal printers optimize workflow, boost productivity, and enhance the overall dining experience for both customers and staff. Automating ticket printing helps reduce the reliance on manual writing or typing, saving valuable time and reducing the risk of human error. For a complete list of printers compatible with this online ordering system, check out the video description below. Before restaurant owners begin setting up their restaurant printer, they must connect it to a power outlet and ensure that there is paper in the printer. They then need to place and hold a small blunt object into the reset button located at the back of the printer. Next, restaurant owners should power on the restaurant receipt printer. A small receipt will be printed initially, asking them not to turn off the printer. They should keep the reset button pressed until a second receipt is printed, displaying the network configuration of the restaurant thermal printer. Restaurant owners will notice that on this piece of paper, there's an IP address. An Internet Protocol IP address is a unique numerical identifier for every device or network that connects to the Internet. It is, in essence, an online device address used for communicating across the Internet. It's the equivalent of a phone number that people pass on to their friends so they know exactly how to reach them. Restaurant owners should put the receipt in a safe place because they're going to need it for the next step. In order for the printer to work, restaurant owners must first enable DHCP. DHCP is a protocol which allows a device, such as the restaurant's printer, to get an IP address from their modem or router. When this is disabled, the printer is hard-coded with a default IP, which is typically not compatible with their network. And if their local network can't talk to their printer, then neither can this online ordering system. To do this, restaurant owners need to temporarily change the IP address of their computer. They need to place their computer in the same network range as their printer. This will allow them to connect to it and change the DHCP setting. Basically, restaurant owners will be creating a small LAN network with the printers so that they can connect with the PC and enable DHCP/auto settings to the printer. To do this, restaurant owners need to connect one end of the Ethernet cable to the printer and the other one to the Ethernet port on their computer. From their computers, restaurant owners should open System Preferences, followed by Network. They need to locate and click on the Ethernet option in the pop-up's left panel. Next, they need to change the Configure IPv4 setting to Manually. Restaurant owners should get the receipt with the network configuration settings that was printed out when they reset the printer. Restaurant owners should pay particular attention to the TCP/IP status section of the receipt. In the IP address field, restaurant owners should enter the IP address of the thermal printer, but change the last two digits to something other than the default IP. This is done to avoid IP address conflicts. Every device that is connected to the restaurant's network needs to have a unique IP address. If more than one device on the restaurant's network has the same IP address, one or both devices will stop working. Next, restaurant owners should change the subnet mask to match what's on the printed receipt. They should then click Apply once they've made the changes. Next, restaurant owners should open their web browser. In the address bar, they need to input the default IP address of their thermal printer. Restaurant owners can add the IP address on the receipt that was printed when they reset the restaurant printer. If restaurant owners are using Google Chrome, they may get a warning message. In this case, they should click on Advanced, followed by the Proceed To link. In some cases, they'll be required to enter a username and password. The default username is Epson, and the password is Epson, or the serial number of their printer. Restaurant owners should consult their printer's owner's manual for the exact login details. In the left navigation, under the Configuration section, restaurant owners should select TCP/IP. They should then select Auto from the Acquiring the IP Address dropdown. Restaurant owners should ensure that the figures in the IP address and subnet mask fields correspond to those printed on the initial receipt with the printer's network configuration. In the default gateway field, restaurant owners should enter the IP address of their router. This will help connect their printer to the internet. To get the IP address of their router, they need to download a third-party network detection app. Network detection apps allow users to see all the devices connected to their network with their IP addresses. Restaurant owners can use any network detection app of their choosing, but for this demonstration, let's use an app called Fing. Restaurant owners can find the Google Play and Apple Store links in the video description below. Restaurant owners should open the Fing app and go through the first-time user questions. They should then click Scan Current Network. Once this scan is complete, restaurant owners will see all the devices connected to their network. Restaurant owners can easily locate their router from the list. It's usually the first one on the list and is identifiable by its router icon. Restaurant owners should make note of the router's IP address and insert it into the default gateway field. They should also note that there's no need to change other options on the page. Restaurant owners should then click Send and then on Reset to finalize the setup. They then need to remove the Ethernet cable from their computer and plug it into their router. This means that the restaurant printer should now be connected to the router. Now, restaurant owners need to open the restaurant order taking app on their mobile device. They should then click on the settings icon at the bottom of the screen, then click on Auto Print Orders. Restaurant owners need to tap on the Add Printer button. They then need to select the network cable or Wi-Fi option followed by Start Search. Then, they need to select their printer once it's been detected by the app. That's it. The restaurant printer is now ready to print receipts. Now let's take a look at how restaurant owners can set up a thermal printer using Wi-Fi. First, they should ensure that the printer is connected to a power source and there is paper in the printer. Restaurant owners need to switch the printer's power button to the off position. Next, they should press and hold the feed button. Restaurant owners should switch the printer on while still holding the feed button. They should not release the feed button until a receipt prints with the printer's network configuration. Restaurant owners should keep the receipt close by because they're going to need it for the next steps. From their computer or mobile device, they need to open System Preferences, followed by Network. Restaurant owners should click on Wi-Fi, then select the network of the thermal printer and click Connect. Once their device has established a connection with the restaurant printer, they should open their web browser. In the address bar, restaurant owners need to type in the default address of the thermal printer. This can be found on the receipt they printed earlier. In the left navigation panel, they should click on Login. The default username is root, and the default password is public. For more information about the printer's login details, restaurant owners should consult the printer's user manual. After they have signed in, they should click on WALN settings. Next, restaurant owners should select infrastructure mode. In the SSID field, they need to type in the name of their Wi-Fi network. Select Auto from the security dropdown. Restaurant owners need to enter the Wi-Fi password in the security key field, then click Submit. They should then click the blinking red Save button in the left navigation panel. Then click Execute. The restaurant printer should reboot automatically, and a new receipt with network configurations should be printed. Next, restaurant owners need to open the restaurant order taking app on their mobile device. They should now click on the settings icon at the bottom of the screen, then click Auto Print Orders. Restaurant owners need to tap on the Add Printers button. Now, they need to select the network cable or Wi-Fi option, followed by Start Search. Restaurant owners should select their printer once it's been detected by the app. That's it! The thermal printer is now ready to print restaurant receipts. Let's take a look at how restaurant owners can print a test receipt. Restaurant owners should open the restaurant order taking app and tap on the options icon. They should then select Create Test Order and then accept the order. All orders will now be automatically printed to the thermal printer using the restaurant receipt template that they've set up in their admin dashboard.